students. So in this chapter ether, today we are going to cover the concept of isomerism and three important physical properties of ethers. Last time we have seen the methods of preparation of ethers. I hope we have revised the reaction and practiced the reactions and you have understood the reactions. So today let us complete this part. Isomerism. From lower standard you are studying the concept of isomerism. So isomerism is a phenomenon in which compounds are having same molecular formula but different structural formula. Now here ethers are showing two types of isomerism. In that first one is functional isomerism and second one is metamerism. So let us start with the first type, that is functional isomerism. We have this example here, CH3OCH3, and the second structure I have written here is CH3CH2OH. Now what is the difference between these two structures, that we have to understand, then you will understand this particular heading. Here this compound is ether, as we know, because two alkyl groups are attached to oxygen, and this compound is alcohol. Now look at the functional group. Here the functional group is O in ethers, and here we have alcohol, functional group is OH. But what is common in both the structures? Let us write down their molecular formula. How many carbon atoms? How many hydrogens? 6. Here 3, 4, 5, 6. How many oxygen? 1. So both the structures are different compounds. One is ether, second one is alcohol, but they have same molecular formula. Their functional groups are different, that's why they are called functional isomers. Okay, so what are functional isomers? Isomers which will have same molecular formula, same molecular formula but different functional groups in them. Okay, they are called as functional isomers. Second one is metamerism. Second type of isomerism is metamerism. Now let us try to understand this example. So here we have first structure ether, second structure of the ether, functional group is same, oxygen. But what is the difference between the two structures, that you have to understand. In the first structure, on both sides of the oxygen atom we have ethyl groups. Alkyl group is ethyl, CH2CH3 CH2CH3. In second example, one alkyl group is propyl group, propyl, 1, 2, 3 carbon atom, propyl group, and second one is methyl group. But what is common in them? What is common? How many carbon atoms? 4. How many hydrogens? 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 10. And here also you can count 10. And how many oxygens? 1. So ethers structures are different, but the molecular formula is same. Okay, such type of they are called as metamers. They are called as metamers. And the isomerism is called metamerism. And of course, as I told you, for the main compounds, always you can give alkylene. So here we have ethoxymethane, here ethoxyethane, then here methoxypropane. Already IUPAC nomenclature we have covered. Okay. अब कंटिन्यू करते हैं फिजिकल प्रॉपर्टीज. दिस कैन बी आस्क्ड इन द फॉर्म ऑफ ड्यूरिज़न. तो आपको यहां पे ध्यान देना है. फर्स्ट फिजिकल प्रॉपर्टी, ईथर डू नॉट फॉर्म हाइड्रोजन बॉन्डिंग. नाउ व्हाट इज द रीजन व्हाई ईथर्स डू नॉट फॉर्म हाइड्रोजन बॉन्डिंग. लेट अस राइट डाउन स्ट्रक्चर. नाउ लुक हियर, दिस स्ट्रक्चर आई एम राइटिंग ओके स्लाइटली डिफरेंट है. शोइंग द प्रॉपर बॉन्डिंग ऑफ ऑक्सीजन आइटम इन ईथर्स. नाउ एज यू कैन सी हियर, ऑक्सीजन इज बॉन्डेड टू डायरेक्टली बॉन्डेड टू कार्बन. टू फॉर्म हाइड्रोजन बॉन्डिंग, हाइड्रोजन आइटम शुड बी बॉन्डेड डायरेक्टली टू ऑक्सीजन. बट इन ईथर्स हाइड्रोजन एटम इज नॉट डायरेक्टली बॉन्डेड टू ऑक्सीजन एटम, दैट्स व्हाई दे डू नॉट फॉर्म हाइड्रोजन बॉन्डिंग. समझ में आया आपको. सेकेंड फिजिकल प्रॉपर्टी है यहाँ पे, अभी ईथर्स हैव लोअर बॉइलिंग पॉइंट, दे हैव लो बॉइलिंग पॉइंट. ओके, ईथर्स ऑफ कोर्स दे आर एग्जिस्टिंग इन लिक्विड स्टेट, दे हैव लोअर बॉइलिंग पॉइंट. द रीजन इज सेम दिस वन, because ethers cannot form hydrogen bonding, that's why they have lower boiling point. Okay, तो reason आपको यही देना है ये point के लिए. अगर आपको give reason पूछा जाता है exam में. And the last third one important, ethers are sparingly soluble in water. What is the meaning of sparingly? Means slightly, not completely soluble. They are slightly soluble in water. Okay, now the reason here is abhi reason dekhte hain. Why ethers are sparingly soluble in water? Because alkyl groups which are attached to oxygen atom in ether are hydrophobic. Ye word hai aapko likhta hoga. तो रीजन क्या है यहाँ पे, ईथर्स आर स्पेरिंगली सोल्युबल इन वाटर बिकॉज अल्काइल ग्रुप्स व्हिच आर अटैच्ड टू ऑक्सीजन एटम इन ईथर्स आर हाइड्रोफोबिक. अभी हाइड्रोफोबिक का मतलब क्या है, वाटर हीटिंग. वाटर हीटिंग मींस दे डोंट लाइक वाटर, दैट्स व्हाई दे आर नॉट कंप्लीटली सोल्युबल इन वाटर. समझ में आपको. Okay, so today we have covered a slightly simple concept because we don't have any reactions here, chemical reactions. Isomerism, two types. Okay, and physical properties, three main physical properties we have covered today. Okay, so you have to revise at home. Already notes I have given. Next time we'll continue with the last part of the chapter, that is chemical reactions of ethers. Okay, so revise this concept properly. Refer my notes, refer your text. Any doubts you can ask. Okay, so that's all for today. We'll continue next time. Have a good day.